Hello and welcome to another review by William and Donal. A few days ago we went to see a movie called Stardust, starring Michelle Pfeiffer, Robert De Niro, Ricky Gervais, Claire Danes, amongst other actors. William, what was this movie about?
Well, to summarise, and there is quite a lot going on, a young man lives in this village in England, and there's a war which leads to a parallel world. Now he breaks all the taboos and goes across the war into this world. And he goes to this market and he meets this girl who's been imprisoned. She's actually a princess. Now, sometime later, a little baby arrives at his house, and that baby is apparently the daughter of the princess. He had a little bit of a menage a deux. The son, isn't it?
Yeah.
The son of the princess. And it's all the same to me, you know, this day and age. But anyway, it's the son of the princess. And down the line, when the son is 18, he likes this girl called Victoria. And they're having a picnic. And there's a shooting star. And she says, if you can go and fetch me that star, find me the star, I'll marry you within the week. Little does he know that he originally comes from the other side of the wall. But to get to the star, he has to go to the other side of this wall. And hence, that's when the movie really gets going. What did you actually think of this movie?
I thought it was great. I'm a big fantasy fan. That's my particular genre that I like. And it kept me on the edge of my seat the whole way through the movie. There was a few different storylines going on, but I found that and each one of them was quite exciting in itself, and I really enjoyed how it all came together in the end. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I thought it was a very good plot, even though maybe some of the storylines have been done before in different films, but just the combination of all of them and how they came together in the end, I thought was really, really good. I thought the performances by Michelle Pfeiffer and Robert De Niro were outstanding. Claire Danes also a star, quite literally, in this movie.
You'll get the joke when you see the movie.
But what about yourself? Did you enjoy this movie?
Well, very much like you, Donald, I really enjoyed it too, and I'm not a fan of fantasy. I was extremely impressed with, as you mentioned, the star appearances by Claire Danes, who took the lead, as well as Robert De Niro, Peter O'Toole, who plays the King at the beginning. You haven't seen him in a lot of films lately. And, of course, for me, Robert De Niro, who I've already mentioned. But Michelle Pfeiffer, what a good sport. She puts on this ugly makeup as a witch. And remember, she is still beautiful.
She's stunning.
Absolutely stunning in real life. And what a good sport. Fair enough, she's probably played millions to do it. Who wouldn't? But anyway, she puts on this makeup. She really does look a sight. But even with the makeup on, she's actually quite... She's quite attractive. I'll do her.
They're ugly. Makeup is fantastic in this movie. I think the costumes
makeup
and everything.
Brilliant.
And the special effects... Second to
you mentioned the plot. Personally for me, yes, there was a lot going on. For me personally, it was too much going on and I couldn't follow it. But even if I couldn't always understand the plot, who cares about the plot? It was a great movie, some brilliant laughs. Now watch out for...
A lot of tongue-in-cheek.
Watch out for Robert De Niro, because I've never been a great fan of his. But for me, he made this movie. And he really goes out of character.
And he shows his versatility.
I'm not going to give away the character he plays, because it is quite a surprise. But it's absolutely brilliant. And for me, absolutely entertaining. And I'm now converted. I actually do like Robert De Niro now.
You know,
he really is the governor. And a brilliant movie. I've got to say, go and see it. As I said, I didn't understand the plot. Sometimes I thought it was wishy-washy. But great fun. Wonderful special effects.
Yeah.
You didn't mention the special effects, did
we? I did. I said they were fantastic.
Really good. Second to none.
Yeah,
brilliant
really
makeup.
Good.
Go and watch it. And I'll tell you what else I liked.
Can I ask you a question? What did you think of some of the minor roles, like Ricky Gervais?
Well, this is where I had the problem. Great movie, but it was rather spoiled by Ricky Gervais. You know Ricky Gervais. He's really just a one-trick pony. It's like this dance he did in The Office. And I mean, since he's done that,
found him the same. He was just Ricky Gervais.
He just plays himself.
That's
and
it.
I don't want to be mean about Ricky Gervais, because I know he's got a lot of fans out there. I've never quite got him myself, but hey, my mum loves him. And really, I just think he's a one-trick pony. I think probably his heyday is a little bit over now. He was great in The Office. For some people, I never got it. I loved him in Extras, but I think the other people made Extras up. But anyway, in this movie, he just played himself, and I'm not a fan of his, and it was a very minor role, yet in the trailers, they use him a lot. And
I don't really understand why, because he is a very minor role in this movie.
It's a very minor role. I obviously think they're trying to appeal to the Ricky Gervais fans. I think it's going to sell to sell to them, because there are a lot of Ricky Gervais fans.
What about other minor roles? Peter O'Toole?
Peter O'Toole was brilliant as the King, but getting back to Ricky Gervais, they obviously thought they could sell the movie by using him, because a lot of fans of The Office, etc., would probably go into this movie knowing Ricky Gervais. But talking of Ricky Gervais, although I can't really stand it, what I liked about this movie is they used a lot of British actors. It's nice to see a movie, a big international movie, not just always using American cast, although nothing wrong with American actors, but being British myself, I do have a certain loyalty, and I like to see British actors employed.
I think the fact that it's set in England, I mean, it would be a real shame not to have British actors in it.
Definitely, and it's brilliant, because in the past they've sometimes used Americans putting on really bad English accents. But would you recommend the movie?
Without a doubt, I love this movie. I would honestly almost give it 5 stars. I can't take away half a star even, so I would give it 4.7, and the reason why I don't give it the full 5 marks is probably because of the role played by Ricky Gervais, to be honest.
I've got to agree, I'm not as generous as him, as Donald. I think I'd probably give it about 3 out of 5. Great movie, as I say. The plot slightly lost it on me, and also Ricky Gervais would have lost half of Mark, which is pretty bad. But a great movie. Go and see it, if only for Michelle Pfeiffer.
Michelle Pfeiffer, Robert De Niro, fantastic.
Go and see it. Oh God, he's always interrupting. He's a rude boy. I didn't bring out him up well. Yeah, go and see it just for Robert De Niro and Michelle Pfeiffer, if anything. It really is a brilliant movie. Go and see it now. If you miss it in the cinema, get it on DVD. Get your friends around. Great fun movie. I wasn't bored once. And I'm the type of person who'll get very tired in the cinema and will want to fall asleep.
We did watch quite a few reviews, maybe, or like read a few reviews about the movie, and I don't understand some of the, like, there's a lot of bad press about this movie, but, you know, if you like fantasy movies, you cannot miss this. You really can't.
As I say, maybe the plot could have been slightly timed up and maybe made a little bit shorter, but apart from that, and get rid of Ricky Gervais, apart from that brilliant movie, 3 stars from me, 5 from Donald.
I'll keep it simple, 4.5.
Go and see it, and we'll talk about another movie soon. Have fun, talk later.
Bye bye.
Bye bye, he's got the wave.